Question 11. For what value of k is 4x squared minus 12x plus k a perfect square? So this is question 11 of WASSCE 2021 elective mathematics. So, you know, this is a quadratic expression, and a equal 4, b equal negative 12, and c equal k. So b squared minus 4ac equals 0 if this is a perfect square. So we substitute the a, b, and c. 12 squared is 144, and this will give us minus 16k. We now solve for k to get 9. And another way you can go about it is to see a squared minus 2ab plus b squared is of the form a minus b all squared. So this form is what is given here. So we have 4x squared minus 12x plus k. So this 2 here must be factored out of this to get 6x inside. So if you compare this and this, you can see that the a is 2x. So the b is what you multiply by 2x to get 6x, which is 3. So you have to square the 3 here so that this whole thing will factor into 2x minus 3 all squared. 2x minus 3 all squared. So it means that the k is 9. K is equal to 3 squared, which is 9. So the answer is a binary operation is defined on the set of real numbers by P star Q is equal to Q squared minus P squared over 2PQ. We have to find 3 star 2. So we just have to substitute P for 3 and Q for 2. And that will give us this expression here. For 2 squared is 4 minus 9, which is 3 squared over 12. And that will give us negative 5 over 12. Evaluate this integral. Negative 2 to 3 of 4x cubed plus 6x squared minus 7 dx. So this is the integral given to us. So integrate and then substitute the limits. So if you integrate 4x cubed, you get 4x exponent 4 over 4. If you integrate 6x squared, you get 6x cubed over 3. For integration, you add to the exponent, divide by the result. And this one, it will give you negative 7x. It's an indefinite integral, so you may choose not to bring this. So this will give us this substitution. And when we substitute, we simplify to get 114 minus 14. And that will give you 100. We have to find the inverse of the matrix given. So to find the inverse of the 2 by 2 matrix, we find the determinant, which is the product of the leading diagonal minus the product of the trace. So that will give us the product of the minor diagonal. So that will give us this negative 8 plus 6, and that will give you negative 2. So the inverse is given by 1 over determinant of this matrix times we swap the leading diagonal, then we negate the minor. So this will give us something like this, and when we divide through, That is, when we use the scalar multiplication of half, we get the result given as this. Question 15. Given that P is such that X is from 0 to 36 inclusive, X is such that X is a factor of 36 divisible by 3, and Q is also 0 to 36 inclusive. X is an even number and a perfect square. We have to find P intersection Q. So let's list the element of each set. So these are the element of set P, and then the element of set Q. Then we have to find the intersection. So the intersection will be 16. The intersection will be 36. That's the only intersection there, 36. We have question 16. A box of mass 15 kg is placed on a rough plane inclined at 60 degrees to the horizontal. If the box is at rest, calculate the normal reaction to the plane. So we're given the gravity due to acceleration to be 10 meters per second squared. Now this over here is the normal reaction is equal to the vertical component, downward vertical of the weight when we resolve it. So mg cos 60 degrees, which is the angle given over here. So this is a diagram for the representing the problem. So we need to substitute the mass, which is 15 kg. Then substitute the gravity due to acceleration, which is 10 meters per second square. Then we simplify to get 75 newtons. 75.0 newtons. Question 17. A fair die is tossed 60 times, and the results are recorded in the table as shown. Find the probability of obtaining a prime number. So the prime numbers are 2, 3, and 5. These are the frequencies. So the number of times is 10. Add all the corresponding frequencies of the prime numbers, which is 10 plus 14 plus 8. And divide by the total outcome, which is 60. That will give you 32 over 60, which is the same as 8 over 15. If 2y squared plus 7 is equal to 3y minus xy, find the y dx. So this is on implicit differentiation. So we have 2y squared plus 7 is equal to 3y minus xy. So now this will we differentiate implicitly. So differentiating this will give you 4y dy dx, because the independent variable is y. If we differentiate it, you have to introduce this, then dy dx, to show that we are differentiating with respect to x. Then if you differentiate a constant, you get 0. If you differentiate this, you get 3 dy dx. So this is a product rule here. So we can bring the parentheses to avoid confusion. So differentiate, hold the x, differentiate the y, you get dy dx. Then hold the y and differentiate the x, you get 1. 1 times y is y. So we can now expand this to obtain this. We now group all the terms containing the y dx on the left hand side over here. So we can now factor the y dx on the left hand side to get this. Now we just divide through by 4y plus x minus 3, and that will give us the answer to be negative y over 4y plus x minus 3. So 3 forces, F1, 8 Newton, 30 degrees, F2, 10 Newton, 150 degrees, and F3, K Newton, 240 degrees, are in equilibrium. Find the value of K. So this is how we go about it. We can resolve all the forces into component form. Then we add all of them and equate to zero if they are in equilibrium. So let me do a rough sketch here. So this the F1 will be in the first quadrant here. So this is F1. Then F2 will be in the second quadrant because it's 150. Then the F3 will be in the third quadrant because it's 240. So we are going to consider the angle it makes with the positive x-axis, or the angle it makes with the direction of a positive x-axis, or simply the angle it's making with the x-axis here. So over here we have 30 here, then over here we also have 30 because this is 150, and we also have 60 here because 180 to 240 is 60. That's what we are getting here. And because this is in the third quadrant, we have negative values for both the x and y coordinate. And this is in the second quadrant, so we have only the x coordinate being negative. This in the first quadrant, so we have this. Now we simplify by substituting the values of the cosine and sine of the respective angles that it makes with the x-axis, and that will give us this result. Now we are going to simplify on the left, and erase the ink. So if we simplify all the x components, we get this. And if we simplify the y component, we get this. So we equate the component to zero, the corresponding component. We have this one equal k over 2 equals equal negative root 3, and that will give us k equal negative 2 root 3. Then we have the vertical component also giving us k over root 3 over 2, k root 3 over 2 equal 9, and that will give us this result, 6 root 3 magnitude. So that corresponds to B over here. Now let's look at this number 30 in triangle PQR. PQ is this, and QR is 4i plus 3j. Find RP. So use the triangular law of vector addition. PQ plus QR should give you PR. So PQ plus QR should give you PR. Now we are looking for RP, not PR, so we negate both sides. When we negate both sides, we know the negative of PR is RP, so that will give us RP. Now we just have to substitute the component given to us here into the vectors, and that will simplify. 5i, 4i will give us 9i. Negative 2 plus 3 will give you positive I, positive j. So this will give us negative 9i minus j as the answer for RP. We are uploading more videos, so don't forget to subscribe to this channel if you have not done so yet, so that if you upload the subsequent ones, you'll be informed. Thanks for watching. If you can still see this red thing here, it means you have not yet subscribed.
So you just have to click it so that the next upload, see it is still red. You have to click it so that if I upload the next video, you'll be informed. Click the bell icon too so that you get a notification whenever I upload a new video. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe.